In this example, I've got a multi-level outline. For my LibreOffice, I've got Calc and Writer as my header level ones. Then I've got Group 1 as my header level 2, and then my actual videos would be my level 3. So let's take a look. If I click on Calc, it's showing Heading 1, Outline 1. My Group 1 is Heading 2, Outline 2, and the same with this Group 2 is also an Outline 2. And these don't have to be personalized. They can be your Heading 2. That's the same thing I did with Heading 1. I created a Heading 2 and then created a format for it. And then as well here, we've got Heading 3. And if we look on here, Organizer linked with Heading 3. And then I'll come down here to Heading 3. And we'll see that that is Outline Level 3 Outline Numbering. So that's where I'm getting the outline from. Now, while we're here, it might be a good time to take a quick look at our navigator. And we see our headings again, our headings tab. It's telling us that we have 20 headings. If I click this open, I've got Calc and Writer. Underneath there, I've got Group 1, 2, and 3. Writer, I've got Group 1, 2. And under here, we've got our video titles. And then double clicking on them will take me right to it. So it is a link. I've left the page above this open, so that's where we're going to place our table of contents. And it starts off the same way. Insert, indexes and tables, indexes and tables. Now we've got multi-levels to look at. Let's change the title, first of all, to LibreOffice TOC, LibreOffice Table of Contents. And we can see right here is what it will look like, because we've got our preview checked. And protect against manual changes, we're going to uncheck that for the entire document. And this outline, this has to do with what we saw down at our bottom of our page, outline mode, index marks, we want those. Let's just click OK and see how it looks just as is. And here we have our LibreOffice table of contents, and we've got our three levels. It's bringing in different looks for levels 2 and 3. Let's take a look at this a little more. To bring back up that dialog box, I'm going to right click and check on Edit Index Table. Now, looking at the styles, we can see level 1 is going to Contents 1, level 2 to Contents 2, level 3 to Contents 3. We can change this if we would like. We can set them all to Contents 1. So I'll put level 1, Contents 1. Level 2, I need to click Contents 1. Now the arrow back, and it changed it to Content 1. Same with level 3, Content 1. Let's click OK. And we see that it all looks like Content 1. I'm not real happy with this style, so I want to change it a little bit. I'm going to change Contents 1, right-clicking, Modify, and I'm going to change the font to Times New Roman and Bold. Apply. Now they're all Times New Roman Bold, so I'm going to change Contents 2, Modify, Times New Roman. I'm going to make that regular 12 point, but I also want to indent this a little bit. It's saying at 120, we'll make this at 135. Apply. And then Contents 3, we're going to modify that. I'm going to make this Times New Roman, italic. And the indent and spacing, the other was 135, so we'll make this 150. Apply, and we don't see any changes because we changed our table of contents. So to do that, we need to right click, index, edit index table. And now I want to change level 2 back to contents 2. Level 3 back to contents 3. And click OK. So now it's looking a little more like I wanted to see. Now let's add some links to our table of contents. Right clicking on it, edit index table, our level 1, we want to click to the left of the E, hyperlink, we see our link start, clicking to the right of the E in that little white box, hyperlink, we see our link end, and we can see over on our left that it looks like it's linked. Let's click OK. And we see in our table of contents the blue, and we also see the control click to open hyperlink. Let's do the same for the other two. Right click, edit index table. Now I go down to level 2, clicking in the white box, hyperlink, link start. I'm clicking in the white box to the right of the E, hyperlink. We see our link end afterwards. We see it. Although they're both here, we still need to go down to our level 3, to our left of our E, hyperlink, to the right of the E, hyperlink. Okay, now they're all in there. Let's make one more change to our table of contents. Right clicking on it, edit index. I want to change our title to be the format of my heading 2. I can't just click OK, need to click this arrow. Now I see it changing here and changing in our preview. Clicking OK. And now we have our formatted multi-level table of contents. I will put these documents that we just covered out on the website in case some of you want to download them and play with them to get a little more familiar with these topics.